Bar graph, bar chart, column chart, column graph, cluster column chart. Forget about all the names. In this video, I turn this data set into this graph in three simple steps. Let's go. Casper from Spreadsheeto here, and the first step to inserting and using column charts, bar charts, whatever, is to select the data that you want to go into the chart. Step two is to insert the actual chart. So go to the insert tab and hit the columns over here. And if I were you, I'd use the clustered column here because it's so useful in almost any situation. So click it and that's it. Awesome, bye. No, don't go yet. So this is the unmodified version of the chart, and it's pretty boring to look at. So step number three is obviously to make it look better and more professional and to make it fit your situation. But before that, please subscribe if you like this video and want to see more videos by me. All right, let's go. I have three tips for you to turn this into something beautiful. So the first tip is to use chart styles. And the chart styles you find if you click the chart and go to chart design, up here there are chart styles. So click this and then you can choose between these pre-made templates for the chart. And if you hover your mouse over them, you can see how they will look when you apply them. So let's go with this one. I like this a lot. Before I show you tip number two, I have a bonus tip for you if you're a little bit ambitious and want to learn more Excel and ratio general level. Go to my website to find my free online Excel training. Link's coming in a second. And here you can choose the level that you want to learn. So if you're a beginner, click here. Intermediate and want to learn if and some if, clean data and VLOOKUP, click here. If you want to learn macros and VBA, you can click the more advanced sections. It takes 30 minutes to complete the training and it's sent directly to your inbox. So just click a button here, enter your email address and I'll send it to you right away. If you want to check it out, go to spreadsheeto.com/YouTube. All right, back to tip number two. And that is that you can add and remove stuff from the chart. And you can do that very easily with a plus sign over here. So click that. And here you can add and remove stuff by checking or unchecking these check marks, obviously. So you can add a trend line, for example, you can add error bars. But the most common things to do are to add or remove these data labels. Now they are included because we choose this awesome chart style before, but if we didn't, it would be great to just add them from here. And now you can see, because I removed them and added them again, the formatting are kind of reset, so they're just added above and we can't see them. So you can actually click over here to choose where you want them to be, like inside base, inside end, inside base. That's pretty cool. Data callout, that's also pretty cool. These options are great, so you want to take advantage of that plus button right away. Tip number three to getting an awesome bar chart is to understand that you can format and remove and edit everything in any chart in Excel, but also in this column bar chart. To do that, just right click. And you can right click anything. If you want to change the color of any of these bars, just click it and click it again, because you can actually see that all the bars are selected now. So if you left click it one more time, only that bar is selected. Right click it, hit the fill button here and choose whatever color you want, like this. Pretty cool, huh? If you want to learn more about charts, please check out my video over here. But if you want to dive deeper into Excel in general, you need to click the link in the description below to join my free online Excel course. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.